first children's appearance, 73 million years ago. 107 billion people have ever lived. And the universe is 40 billion years old. Now, those are very big numbers, aren't they? We could fathom how big they are. Try, but you can't. Now, this number is very small, isn't it? Guess what it is? Guess what does it represent? So, what do you think? Some of you might think it's the age of the first human civilization. It might be the number of all the languages in the world. Or it might be the number of people interested in it. Say you live to 100 years old. That's the amount of weeks you're gonna live. Pretty small, isn't it? Compared to this. Well, let's say you're 60 years old. You have lived for 850 weeks. That leaves you in the moderate 400. Let's say you're gonna have a job. You're gonna work 40 hours a week. You're gonna have a family, and you're gonna sleep 8 hours a day. You're gonna live about 1,500 weeks a week. Personal time. Very, very small, isn't it? Compared to these juggernauts. Very, very small. Well, some of you might think, what does this have to do with learning? What does that have to do with developing myself? Well, I want you all to have that question in the back of your mind. All of you. And by the time this speech ends, some of you might realize the answer. Now, I'm gonna speak about the five attributes of a communicator. Confident. Everybody has to be confident in life. Love, work, friends, you have to be confident in all those things. I'm a great example. Look at me. Well, let us tell what they're for. I'm gonna talk about the responsible, reflective, and innovative things. Not define them, but I'm gonna show you all an example. And it's not gonna be boring, trust me. So let's say you are given an assignment. But it's too hard. You can't do it. So it's the responsible thing to do is tell them you can do it. I can't do it. I'm sorry. And that's very responsible, isn't it? Reflective trait. How you can realize what you can do, why you can do it, your shortcomings. That's pretty reflective. Not gonna lie, the innovative thing, being able to overcome the problem with you. being able to come up with new solutions, you ways to improve yourself. Like I am. I just forgot this. I'm gonna memorize it next time. Well, let's talk about the last subject, the attribute. Engaged. And in my personal opinion, this is the most important one. Being engaged in what you do will give you the interest. Hold on. Intrinsic motivation. Wow. Weird word, isn't it? Most of you haven't heard it, probably. So, this is the intrinsic motivation. After I do the lesson. You see that? That's what I'm talking about. Interesting motivation. And there's the extrinsic motivation. I'm gonna sum this up as basically doing something because you either have to do it or you don't. You have to do it. Like you want to gain a prize, good grades, stuff like that. Or to avoid punishment. That's pretty much one time thing. You might learn something for now, but you're not gonna remember it. Intrinsic motivation on the other end is doing something because you want to. I did this speech because I wanted to. Not because I have to, but because I want to. This stuff's gonna stick to you. Like, you're not gonna forget something you personally enjoyed doing. This. Can somebody read this? After this? Anyone?
The future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of their dreams.
Thank you! Thank you. Clap, clap, everyone. So, the future belongs to those who believe in the beauty of the dream. What is beauty? What do you think? For some, it might be their facial features, like how their face looks, how their hair is. For some, might be how it's cool with their bodies. So it might be the innocence of someone, like that little child, definitely innocent, cute, and charming. Well, think about it for a minute. For a minute, I'm sorry. Everybody has their own Everyone has their own perception of beauty. What is life? Think about it. What is life if there is no beauty in it? Think about it for a moment. Pretty deep, isn't it? I'm very deep. Some of you might not think of yourself beautiful, or might think of others as ugly. Some of you might think that. I'm not gonna lie. I also used to think that when I was a child. Now I'm a grown adult, in my opinion. I'm gonna give you an example of the plant's world. This world is rusty, not ugly. Would a warrior ever take a plant's world to a battlefield? No, they won't. Yeah, some of you right now are that fool. They look at you, they say it's useless. It has no potential. It can't deal any damage. But when you start dropping that sword against a redstone, every day, constantly, it's gonna retain its sharpness. It's gonna keep its all life-altering capabilities and so on. And eventually, it will become so sharp, it's gonna it's gonna rifle straight legendary king of this world, and you will become the king of yourself, the king of intelligence, king of what you are right now, what you will be in the future. Are two different people with different characteristics, different personalities, attitudes, and achievements. I want to ask you all, what is it? What is being a human? What makes us humans special? Well, I think. I think that we can think. I think that we can think. Yeah. Yeah. Looking at this, what do you think? This empty space, this. What do you all think? Do you think an animal can think that? education, work, motivation, those are things necessary for life. But art, poems, beauty, love, those are the things that we live for. Those are the things that make us human. I mean, work, eat, sleep, that's everything that an animal can do.